forth of it, and his journey from fun and gain to adventure, to his conviction and confession to repentance. He wears no crown, for his son Absalom has taken it by force. David has no home. Those walls rising to his back belong to the city of Jerusalem. He is fleeing the very capital that he founded. No throne, no home, no Jerusalem, no power. How does a king end up old and lonely and on an uphill path? Well, let's just ask David. David, how are your children? He winces as you bring up the subject. 14 years have passed since David seduced Bathsheba. 13 years since Nathan told David, "The sword shall never depart from your house." And Nathan's prophecy has proved painfully true. One of David's sons, Amnon, fell in lust with his half-sister Tamar, one of David's daughters, by a mother. And Amnon pined and plotted until finally he raped her. And after he had raped her, he discarded her like an old worn-out dog. Tamar, when the scandal came undone, she threw ashes on her head and tore the robe of many colors that was worn by the virgin daughter of the king. She remained desolate in her brother Absalom's house. And when King David heard of all these things, he was very angry. And isn't there something else to follow? Because we expect to read that David was very angry and he confronted Amnon, or he punished Amnon, or he banished Amnon. But David did nothing. There was no penalty, no imprisonment, not even a dressing down. David did nothing to Amnon. And worse, he did nothing for Tamar. She needed his protection, his affirmation, his love. She needed a dad. And what she got was silence. So Absalom, her brother, filled the void. He sheltered his sister. He plotted against Amnon and got him drunk and then killed him. Incest, deceit, one daughter raped, another son dead, another still with blood on his hands. His palace was in turmoil and his royal family was at each other's throats. And again it was time for David to step up, to display some of that Goliath-killing courage, some of that battlefield leadership that he had become known for. But again, David did nothing. Absalom fled to Jerusalem to hide. And then he flew away from it. And David made no attempt in 3 years to see him. When Absalom returned to Jerusalem, David still refused to see him. Absalom married, had 4 children, and dwelt in Jerusalem for 2 full years, but never saw his face. Now you might think that such shunning would be easy, but avoiding Absalom as the son of the king demanded real thought and effort on David's part. But then again, David had always been successful in neglecting.